वागीशात्या सुमनतः सर्वार्थानां उपक्रमे यम् नत्वा कृतकृत्यास्य भूतं नमामि गजाननम् पार्थाय प्रतिबोधितम् भगवता नारायणेन स्वयम् व्यासेन कृतितम् पुराणमुनिना मध्ये महाभारतम् अद्वैतामृतवर्षिणीम् भगवतीम् अष्टादशाध्यायिनीम् अम्बत्वा मनसं ददाति भगवद्गीते भवद्वेषी सदाशिवसमारम्भाम् शङ्कराचार्यमध्यमाम् अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्ताम् वन्दे गुरुपरम्पराम् योगिनम् विश्वनाथात्यम् अस्मत्तात स्वरूपिणम् आत्मलाभात् परम् लाभम् वक्ता आरम् न कदाचन गीतार्थग्रन्थकर्तारम् श्रीगुरुम् प्रणमाम्यहम् योऽन्तः प्रविश्य मे वाचम् धृतिम् बुद्धिम् प्रचोदयात् ॐ नमः सभाभ्यः सभापतिभ्यश्च वो नमः ॐ फ्रेंड्स दिस् इस् दि 27th सेशन् आफ् गीता रेजिमन् फार् अद्वैतिक् लिविङ्ग् We are going to see shlokas in the fifth chapter, from first shloka to the 12th shloka of the fifth chapter. Remember, today it is going to be an important session. You know why? Because every one of us, any reader of the Gita, has always a doubt, either halfway or even after reading it fully. The main doubt, it is a universal doubt. A very legitimate, of course. That doubt is, finally, what is Krishna recommending? Is he recommending renunciation of works, or is he recommending doing of works? This is a fundamental doubt that, this is a doubt that everybody has. So, today we are going to give a right answer to that question. He not only had this doubt at this point of time in the beginning of the fifth chapter, he had it at the beginning of the third chapter, he is going to have it again at the beginning of the 18th chapter. But it so happens that in the fourth chapter, the Lord is so emphatic in answering it, and Acharya Shankara gives us the right interpretation for this. So that is what we are going to see today, and that is why I call this an important session. अर्जुन उवाच संन्यासं कर्मणां कृष्णयोरेकं तन्मे ब्रूहि सुनिश्चितम् सी द गीता लैंग्वेज इज वेरी सिंपल एलिमेंटरी संस्कृत विल गिव यू द मीनिंग्स बट द प्रोफाउंड मीनिंग्स विल हैव टू बी टेकन फ्रॉम द कमेंटरीज द सिंपल मीनिंग हियर इज संन्यासं कर्मणां कृष्ण कृष्ण हे कृष्ण कर्मणां संन्यासं कर्मणां मीन्स एक्शंस वर्क्स Sannyasam, renunciation. Renunciation of works. You are praising some other time, in the same breath, you are also praising yoga, karma yoga. That is doing of works, you are praising. Renunciation of works, you are also praising. Come on, don't confuse me like this. Yachreya yetayoho ekam tamme bruhi sunishchitam. Yetayoho ekam yeti shreyaha. Of these two, Yatayoho, tell me one of them, whatever is good to me, whatever is ultimately good to me, Shreyaha, Shreya Yatayoho Ekam, Tati, that one, Me Bruhi Sunishchitam, please tell me with certainty. I mean, don't confuse me. So, this is the elementary meaning of this shloka. Arjuna asks, as he told you, the same question, he asked it at the beginning of the third chapter. Jayasi chayat karmanasse mata buddhyat janardana satkim karmani ghore maam niyoti jasi keshabha. If karma is buddhi, if karma is better than buddhi, their buddhi is for the jnanata type of thing. So, if karma is greater than jnana, jayasi chayat karmanasse mata buddhyat janardana, then why are you prodding me on to this war, this karma? This is the question he asked there. And again, here he has asked the same question. Later in the 18th chapter, he is going to ask, Sanyasasya Mahabaho Tattvamichyami Veditam Tyagasya Tahrishikesha Sanyasa and Tyaga Sannyasa is renunciation. Tyaga is doing the action without doership. That is renunciation of the agency of action, still doing the action. That is the tyaga. Between these two, what is best? That is what he is asking. Of course, in the third chapter, he very clearly said, Jnana Yogena Sankhyanam. By Sankhyas, he means philosophers. Those who are intellectually oriented in terms of philosophy. Jnana Yogena Yoginam. Yogi is the people who are more attached to works, more prone to work. Yogina Karma Yogena Yoginam. For them, Karma Yoga. So two types of people he has said. And then he answers the third chapter and the other things. So that completes it. But in the fourth chapter, he is again starting complex statements. Karma karmanya karmaya pasyeti. Akarmanicha karmaya, 18th shloka, the famous 18th shloka. Sayukta krishna karmagrate, he who can see action in inaction, and inaction in an action, he is the one who sees, he understands karma, he says. So, even when one is doing karma, so that is the 18th shloka of 4th chapter. Yadan. In next shloka, Yanatmidaddha karmanam tamahu panditam mugavaha yasya sarve samarambhaha kama sankalpa varjitaha Yanatmidaddha karmanam. The famous statement of Yanatmidaddha karmanam by Jnana Agni, fire of wisdom, actions. That's what he is saying. Yanatmidaddha karmanam. So it appears as if that Jnana is going to destroy or consume all the actions, so Jnana is the better one. That is obviously the meaning there. Again, Shariram Kevalam Karma, number 21. Shariram Kevalam Karma, Kurvanna Pranoti Kilbisham. Only for the maintenance of the body you do any action. All the actions are only for the maintenance of the body, not for the fruits of the actions. So again, actions are under. Then look at 22. Yadri chalaba santushto dundvatito vimatsara. Whatever comes to you, whatever comes to you by God's will, by the will of God, be satisfied with that. Yadri chalaba santushto dundvatito vimatsara. Am I devoid of all dualities? Right? That is the one. He reaches the supreme. And in the next shloka, the famous theoretical shloka, Brahmarpanam Brahmadavikirmatmam Brahmanakutam, everything is Brahman. The ladle is Brahman, the offering is Brahman, the fire is Brahman, the action is Brahman, the action being you being the agent of the action or anything like that. And in 32 he says, after describing all the various yajnas he describes, he says, karmajan vidhitan sarvane evam janatva vimokshase. All these yajnas, don't think they are great, they are all born of karma. They are all associated with karma. They are dependent on janatvan vidhitan sarvan evam janatva vimokshase. So, this is no good. You have to go beyond that action. Evam jnatva vimokshasim. You cannot depend on action, he says. On those yajnas, you cannot depend on them. And that is why he says in the next shloka, sarvam karma khilam partha jnane parisamapyate. He says, shreyam dravyamayat vijnate jnana yajna parantapa. All these materials are connected, associated, or anchored to material things. Dravyamayat yajnyat shreya dravyamayat yajnyat jnana yajnya parantapa. Jnana yajnya is great. So he is saying sarvam karma, all the actions are consumed. Karma khilam partha jnana parisamapyate. Finally end up only in jnana. So jnana is the greater one. Jnanagni sarva karmani Basmasat Kurutarjuna, or the fire of Vishramani, Basmasat Kurutarjuna, just as fire consumes all the pieces of wood thrown into it. After, and again you look at the final concluding sloka, of fourth chapter. Yogasam yastakam manam jnana sanchinna samshayam chitravinam samshayam yogam atishto trittabhata yogam atishta. After saying so much about jnana throughout the almost in the latter half of the fourth chapter, from 18th sloka to yogasam yastakam manam, by yoga you have having renounced all the actions. Yoga matishta, practice that yoga, chitvainam samshayam, your doubts will all clear, and yoga matishta, he says. So the whole business seems to be yoga, that is karma yoga, versus sannyasa. And sannyasa has been glorified here, and that is why, you know, Arjuna is very smart. He follows Krishna very closely. And he asks the right questions at the right time. And there is a continuous flow of thought. It is not as if each chapter is a kind of a separate treatise on some idea. No. It is a continuous flow of thought until chapter 1 to chapter 18. So he asks, sannyasam karmanam Krishna punaryogam cha samsasi. You are talking between these two. What is better? Tell me with certainty. And Krishna replies, second sloka, sannyasa karma yogascha nishreyasa karavubho tayostu karma sannyasat karma yogo visishyate. Both sannyasa and karma yoga. Sannyasa is renunciation, karma yoga is the doing of works. According to karma yoga, karma yoga means ma phaleshu kadachana ma karma phalaveshu bhu. Do not hanker after the fruits of the actions. Yogastha kuru karmani sangam tattva dhananjaya. Be in yoga. Discard all associations. Sangam tattva. Yogastha kuru karmani sangam tattva dhananjaya. Siddhya siddhya samo bhutva samatvam yoga uchyate. Success and failure, be equal, equanimous to both success and failure. The samatvam is called yoga, says shloka number 47 and 48 in the second chapter. So, that karma yoga, that is karma yoga. Sannyasana is renunciation of works. Both are good, both will lead you to the goal. Nishreyasa karau ubau, ubau both. Nishreyasa karau means will do you good, will take you to the ultimate good, supreme good. So you see that slightly a kind of a mischievous, I can visually imagine what he will be doing at that time. Slight with a smile, he says, tayostu karma sanyasati karma yogo visishyate. But karma sannyasa, better than karma sannyasa, it is karma yoga that distinguishes. Vishishyate. Do you follow now? Sannyasa karma yoga, both will, in the second line he says, tayosu, between them, karma sannyasa, renunciation of works, other than renunciation of works, karma yoga distinguishes itself. Karma yoga is better. The whole point about these 12 shlokas is, it gives you emphatically of the word sankhya, sannyasa, yoga, these things. So renunciation of works, when he says karma sannyasat, what is karma sannyasat? Ha ha, dog, Krishna has said, throw away all the work, so I am not going to do any work. I am not going to the temple, I am not going to do any puja, I am not going to do the ritual rites. No, this is an attitude, this is karma sannyasat. That is, renunciation of works, probably because of inability, renunciation of work. By works you mean prescribed works. Niyatam karma. The shastras are prescribed you works. Matra devo bhava, pitru devo bhava, acharya devo bhava, namnyana madhyani karmani, thani sevitavyani, yanyana madhyani karmani, thani sevitavyani, mohitaradi. Nothing else. What has been traditionally prescribed, traditionally honored, which has to be obeyed, followed. Nothing else. So if you throw away those works, without real knowledge, it is not there in the text. But as you go along in the fifth chapter, you will understand this. So renunciation of works without real knowledge, this is called mere renunciation. Just saying, I am lazy, I am not going to do that. Why should I get up? You see? So, such a renunciation is a resort. Who can renounce works? After dispassion, thorough dispassion, vairagya has set in when he comes of that kind of kramam, krodham, balam, darpam, vimuchya, all those things, desire, anger, everything has to be discarded. And at that stage, automatically you become eligible for renunciation of works. You can't renounce your works because it is difficult for you to do it, because you don't like it, because you have so-called other works to do. No. So that is called karma sannyasa. Better than that, karma yoga visishyate. That renunciation is no good. This is the understanding. Be very clear about it. We will be explaining this, almost the same thing, again and again in the next 7 or 8 shlokas. Third, Nyeyasa nitya sanyasi yonadveshti nakankshati nirdvandu himagabaho sukham bandhat pramuchyate. He is a perpetual renouncer. Who? Saha nitya sanyasi nyeyaha yaha na dveshti. He who does not hate, does not shun, na kamkshati, does not seek, does not desire. Okay? So, he who does not, neither shuns nor seeks, whether it be pain or pleasure, or the means to attain that pleasure or the pains, he who does not shun or seek, he is a nitya sannyasi. Nirdvandu himagabaho sukham bandhat pramuchyate. Mahabaho, hey Arjuna, nirdvandaha, whoever is devoid of all dualities, all contraries, whoever is devoid of all dualities or all contraries, such a person, without any effort, sukham bandhat pramuchyate. Sukham bondage. He is released from bondage very easily. Whoever is devoid of all dualities, pleasure, pain, joy, sorrow, anything. Of course, now there arises the question. Sannyasa and karma yoga are for two different types. Jnana yogena sankhyanam, karma yogena yoginam, sankhya people, jnana yoga. Yogis, the action-oriented people, karma yoga. So their fruits also must be different. So how do you say nishreyasa karana vibhav? Both are leading to the same good, ultimate good. Why are you saying that? The answer comes in the next shloka. Pratak balaha pravadanti na pandito ekam apyasthita samyak ubhayor vindate palam. Difficult shloka. Because Sankhya and Yoga have to be understood correctly. What is Sankhya? He started with between sannyasa and karma yoga. But Krishna in his answer slowly takes it to a higher level and talks about Sankhya and Yoga. Sankhya Yoga Upratat Balaha Pravadanti. Sankhya means renunciation with knowledge, underline, with knowledge. Perfect knowledge of the self. Sankhya means renunciation with knowledge, not renunciation for the sake of renunciation. No, no, no. Yoga also means partha yoga. What is that? Karma yoga together with knowledge and its means. What are the means for the knowledge? Equality of vision. Samatvam. Samatvam yoga uchyate. So, equality of knowledge. The real day, that is called real yoga. Called real yoga. Excuse me. So yoga is that here Sankhya Yoga Pratak Balaha Prabhadanti Napanditaha. Only childish about Sankhya and Yoga as different. Panditas, scholars, knowledgeable people will not talk like that. That is just like Sankhya Yoga Pratak Balaha Prabhadanti Napanditaha. So here Sankhya means renunciation with together with the Samadra Buddhi and knowledge. So that ekamapyasthita samyake ubhayor vindate palam. Even if you follow one of them, ekamapi asthitaha samyak. If you follow one of them, if you practice one of them, well, samyake ubhayor vindate palam. The whatever can be got, obtained by both of them, the same phala will be got. That is, both of them will give you the samyak ubhayor vindate palam. So Sankhya means renunciation with knowledge, and yoga means paramatma knowledge, and its means samatvam. And therefore he emphasizes that in the next sloka, yat sankhya prapyate sthanam tad yogairapi gamyate. Krishna is a very good teacher. When he knows that he is talking about a very complex subject, he drives it home, and a little change of language. Yat sankhya prapyate sthanam tad yogairapi gamyate. That is why I said this is an important lesson. This will clear all our doubts. Ekam sankhyam cha yogam cha yah pashyati sah pashyati. Whatever is obtained, whatever fruit is obtained by sankhya, yati sankhyaihi prapyate sthanam. Whatever position is obtained by sankhya, tad yogairapi gamyate. That is obtained even by yoga. Remember Sankhya and Yoga, renunciation with knowledge, K capital, not simple, ordinary, material knowledge, no, knowledge of the absolute, perfect conviction. And yoga means real yoga done with samatva buddhi in the karma yoga way described in the second chapter and the third chapter. So who are the real yogins? The real yogins are those who don't seek the fruits of works for themselves. They perform karma, dedicating all of them to God as a means. Doing action is a means of gaining knowledge. Jnana praptyartham. They have to obtain jnana. They perform karma, dedicating all of them to God as a means for gaining knowledge. And so finally they reach the state of liberation. How? Through the knowledge of the absolute and renunciation of all works. Karma will... So renunciation of works. That is why Lord Shankara, Acharya Shankara says, Ishware samarpya karmani atmanaha phalam anabhisandhaya anudrishtanti ye te yoginaha. Who are the yogins? Ishware samarpya karmani. Dedicate all their actions to God. They do not seek any fruit for themselves. Anabhisandhaya, phalam anabhisandhaya. Not seeking the fruit of any action for themselves. anutishtanti, yogam anutishtanti. Whoever follows this, te yoginaha, they are the yogis. They are the yogis. You see, steadfastness in action, karma yoga, you be steadfast in that and do it proud. Ultimately, it will lead to steadfastness in knowledge preceded by monasticism. You see, this renunciation, where we are all talking about sannyasa, sannyasa is great, sannyasis are respected. So that is the monasticism. You cannot throw away works just like that and become a sannyasi. Taking action, you cannot become an aishkarmya siddhi. You cannot get the actionlessness part. You cannot become a sannyasi just by throwing away all your actions. Nacha sannyasana deva siddhim samadhi gacchati. You cannot obtain the goal. Therefore, steadfastness in knowledge, right, should precede that monasticism. An unenlightened person hankering for liberation, what should he do? He should perform karma yoga, sattva suddhyattam, for the purification of the mind. Monasticism will follow automatically when dispassion comes. So in the previous janma, if you have done the karma yoga properly as a dedication to God without hankering for the fruits of actions, in the next janma perhaps you will get the sannyasa eligibility because dispassion would have come. That is why here he says sankhya and yoga are the same thing. They will lead to the same goal. Ekam sankhyam cha yogam cha yah pashyati sa pashyati. Ekam sankhyam cha yogam cha yah pashyati sa pashyati. Whoever sees sankhya and yoga as one, he is the one who is the right seer. Yah pashyati sa pashyati. Who sees? He sees. What does he mean? What is this mystic language? Yatsankhe prapyate sthanam sadyoga erapi gamyate yekam sankhyancha yogancha yapashyati tapashyati. And therefore he says the reason. Why? Because this sannyasa otherwise is very difficult to get, to be steadfast in it. Sannyasa dukkhamaptuma yogatagam yoga yukto muni brahma nachidena adigacchati. And recall that shloka which I told you just now, nakarmana manarambhavati. By not starting any action, you cannot become actionless. Just by throwing away all your actions, sannyasana deva, you cannot attain the goal. Renunciation is really hard to win without yoga. That's what the first line says. Sannyasastumagamabhavo dukkhamaptumai. Sannyasaha aptum dukkham. It's very difficult to obtain sannyasa. Yoga yukto muni brahma. But if you are properly following the yoga, the karma yoga, Vedic karma yoga, what do you mean by Vedic karma yoga? Dedication means prescribed actions by scriptures, by your teachers, Matra Devo, Bhava Pitra Devo, Bhava, like that. Such a sage, such a yogi, Brahman. What is Brahman here? Brahman means real renunciation. There is an Upanishad called Mandukya, Mahanarayana Upanishad. Mahanarayana Upanishad. You know, Krishna Yajurveda is so big. Of course, Rigveda is bigger, that is different. Krishna Yajurveda itself is big. It contains a Samhita portion, which is Brahmana portion, another 1/8 of the whole thing, and then an Aranyaka portion, another 1/8 of the whole thing, and then there is an Upanishads, the last portion of Aranyaka. Samhita, Brahmana, Aranyaka Upanishad. So in the Krishna Yajurveda, the Upanishad is at the end, comes Saittiriya Upanishad. But even another Upanishad comes after that is called Mahanarayana Upanishad. That is the last portion, very last sentence. I am telling you now. Nyasayiti Brahma Hiparaham Parohi Brahma Tanivayetanyavarani Tapadamsi Nyasayevatyarechayate Evammele Etyupanishate. Finished. That is the ending of Krishna Yajurveda. What does it say? It says Nyasayiti Brahma. Renunciation is Brahman. Is Parohi Brahma Tanivayetanyavarani. All the other tapas, all the other rituals, sacrifices, actions, they are all avarani, of lower level. Jnasa evacchare chet. It is sannyasa, renunciation, that tops all. That is the topper. Right? Evacchare chet. Evam mele etyupanishate. This is the sum and substance of all Upanishads. Final word of Upanishad. So, that Brahma, Yoga Yukta, look at this shloka now. Adigachati, Yoga Yukta, the one who is perfected in that Vedic Karma Yoga, dedication of works to God without craving for their fruits. He is the Muni, Mananath Munihi. You see, he has mentally lived on that mantra, on those ideas for a long, long time until it becomes one with him. He is a Muni. Brahma Nachirena Sannyasa Brahma. Sannyasa is Brahman. Brahman is Sannyasa here. Achirena Adigachati. Very soon he obtains that. He continues that idea in the next shloka. Number 7. Yoga Yukto Vishuddhatma Vijitatma Jitendriyam Sarvabhutatma Bhutatma Kurvannapi Nalipyate Kurvannapi Nalipyate. This is a standard refrain in the Gita and in the Upanishad. Kurvannapi Nalipyate. Even though he might be doing action, Kurvannapi Nalipyate. Nothing touches him. Why? Because Yoga Yukto Vishuddhatma. In the yoga discipline, Vishuddhatma, his self, mind, is purified. Vijitatma, he has conquered his self. Jitendriyaha, right? He is speech, mind and body. Walk, manas, kaya, danda, staff. That is why the sannyasis are called tridandi. They who have conquered speech, mind and body. These three things are under their control. That is why they are called Tridandi. This is a Manuspruti shloka anyway. Anyway, this Vijitatma Jitendriya, such a person, Yoga Yukta, who has perfected in yoga, Sarva Bhutatma Bhutatma. Beautiful phrase. Underline it, mark it in red. Sarva Bhuta Atma Bhuta Atma. Sarva Bhuta Atma Bhuta Atma. Sarvesham Bhutana. All living beings. Atma Bhutaha. His self has identified with the self of all beings. He has identified his self with the self of all beings. That is why when Shuka Brahman was going there, Vyasa called Shuka and all the trees answered that call. You know, Sarva Bhutatma Bhutatma. He is a Samyak Darshi. He is the right percipient. Vannapi na lipyate. So, Yoga Yuktaha, Vishuddhatma, Vijitatma, Jitendriyaha, Sarva Bhutatma Bhutatma. 5 qualifications are given for this great seer. Kurvannapi na lipyate. Even though he is doing actions, nothing touches him. He describes that nothing touches him in slow motion. Beautiful sloka. Next. Naivada. Naivakin chitkaro mhiti yukto manyeta tattvavit पश्यन् शृण्वन् स्पृशन् हृद्घ्रम् अश्नुम् गच्छन् श्वसन्नपि प्रलपन् विसृजन् गृह्णन् उन्मिषन् निमिषन्नपि इन्द्रियाणीन्द्रियार्थेषु वर्तन्त इति धारयन्. The indriyas are associating themselves with the objects, sense objects. The senses are playing, vartante, or living, or playing with their sensavite, that philosopher, that man who knows sarva bhutatma bhutatma, previous sentence. He is a yuktaha, he is perfected in yoga. He says, naiva kinchit karomi iti, na eva kinchite karomi iti, I do not do anything. This samyakdarshi, he thinks, I work not at all. Naiva kinchit karomi iti, yukto manyeta tattavite. He describes doing anything. Even though he might be doing kurvan napi, that is elaborated in two lines, it's slow motion. Pashyan, shinvan, sprishan, jigran, ashnan, gachan, shosan, api, pralapan, visrijan, grinnan, unmishan, nimishan, api. Pashyan, seeing, shinvan, hearing, sprishan, touching, jigran, smelling, ashnan, eating, gachan, walking, Shrasan, breathe, visrijan, what shall I say, visrijan when he is answering nature's calls, grinnan, taking in something, unmishan, nimishan napi, whether he is waking or sleeping, indriya ani indriya teshu vartanta iti dharayan, he knows that the indriya senses are closeting, right, or playing with the indriyarthas. That is all. I have nothing to do with it. Naiva kinchit percipients, perception. He sees only non-work in all actions. Non-work. In work. What work? Of the psycho-physical organism. Seeing, hearing, touching, smelling, eating, everything. Whether it is the jnana, anendriyas or karmendriyas. So, the thing to do for him, this is the tattva-vithi. Brahmanyadhaya karmani, next shloka. Brahmanyadhaya karmani, sangam tyaktva karoti yagam, lipyate nasapapena, padmapatramivambhasa. He is not touched by any sin. Lipyate papena na. Padma patram iva ambhasa. Just as a lotus leaf is not touched or tainted or soiled or wetted by water. Padma patram iva ambhasa. This is a famous analogy. It is a well-known analogy throughout India. It is in the culture. It is built. The source is this, of course. Source is the Upanishad, but this is the major source. Padma Patramiva Ambhasa. For whom? Brahmani Adhaya Karmani Sangam Chattva Karotiyaka. Reposing all works in Brahman. Brahmani Adha Brahmani. Reposing all works in him. Sangam Chattva. All associations. All associations, tattva, discarding, tainted by any of the actions. He thinks, I work for the sake of God, as a servant of the same, as a master, for my master, without attachment even to the fruit of the actions, even to the fruit of liberation. Such a person is not stained by sin. He is not unstained by water. It's a famous phrase, as I told you. What is the fruit of such kind of work? Purification of the self. The only fruit of such work is purification. That is why the next shloka says, Kayena manasa buddhya kevalair indriyairapi yogena daye. Kayena by body, manasa by mind, buddhya by intellect, kevala merely by body, merely by mind, merely by intellect. The kevala has to go with kayena manasa buddhya. Kevalena kayena manasa kevalena buddhya kevalena indriya irupi. All the sense, all the senses, body, mind or intellect, just by merely by them, yoginaha karangam tattva, renouncing, discarding all associations. For why do they do this? Atma shuddhaye. Atma shuddhaye does not mean purification of one's self. The self is always pure. Purification of the mind. Purification of the mind. Ishwaraya iva karomi, I am doing all actions only for God. Na mama phalaya, Shankara's commentary. It's not for the fruit of any action, not for any fruit for myself. Yukta karma phalam tattva, and beautiful summary. Yukta karma phalam tattva shanti matmanoti naishtiki. The one who is perfected in yoga, yukta karma phalam tattva, discarding, renouncing all the fruit of actions, karma phalam, tyatva, shanti vapnoti naishtikim. Naishtikim, what is that permanent peace? Naishtikim, shantim, it is, right? That is the final salvation, so to say. Ayuktaha, on the other hand, the one who is not perfected himself in yoga, kamakarena, phale satto nibhadyate, because of he's full of karma. Kara, kama, kara. Kara here means karana. By the instrument of desire, phale satto nibhadyate, he is attached to the fruit. And hivalam tattva shanti mapnoti naishtikim, I work for the sake of God, not for the fruits. Such a person, he obtains the permanent salvation. What are the steps? Acharya Shankara describes the steps. Sattva Shuddhi, Jnana Prapti, Karma Sanyanasa, Jnana Nishtha, then Moksha. Sattva Shuddhi, mental purification, that's the first thing. Yukshan with the dedication to God for mental purification. That is our first goal. Then that gives you achievement of knowledge. Then the thing will strike. Right? Aham Brahmasmi. Karma sannyasa, it is at that stage, only after that stage, the works will. Banana being held by a child sleeping by itself slips away without its knowledge. The works have to slip away from you. That is the renunciation of works. Then comes the jnana nishtha, consecration to the discipline of knowledge. Then you are anchored, stabilized in that knowledge. Ayuktaha, so yuktaha karma balam chattva, it is at that stage, shanti mahapranoti naishtiki. As you see, therefore, these 12 shlokas are telling us the distinction between the so-called sannyasa and the so-called karma yoga. We should not mistake the meanings of these two words, neither sannyasa nor karma yoga, nor sankhya nor this yoga. I have told you these things. So with that we will stop today. We will continue in the next session. So siprajabhya paripalayantam yayeda markeda mahim mahisho god brahmane bhyashuvam astu nityam lokasya mastas sukino bhavantu. Om Tat Sat.